Hey, how's everyone doing? I just got back from my first ever Slash featuring Miles Kennedy in the Conspirators concert, and man, do I got a lot to tell you guys about. My ears are still ringing, and I've been out of the venue for like 2 to 3 hours at this point. So this was in Orlando at the Hard Rock. Second time I've ever been there. First time was actually the first ever concert I went to, which was Primus back in 2014. So it's been a while since I've been there, obviously. I got there a little later than I wanted to, but man, it was packing up really quickly. My ticket was about 70 bucks, but with fees and all that other bullshit, it was like 100. At first, I didn't see any merchandise stands, but after walking around a little bit, I did find the merchandise stand, which is at the front of the venue. The line was really long, and it kind of sucked because you couldn't see the merchandise before you got there. So basically, you had to wait in line the whole time before you could even see what merchandise there was. I was really hoping I wouldn't wait in line for 20 fucking hours and then go there and be like, oh shit, I don't want anything. So I was cutting it really close on time because it was almost 8 o'clock. So I get over to the merchandise. And I'm looking around, and they had a decent amount of stuff, probably a little bit less than what Kiss had at the last concert I went to. I decided on a tour shirt and a tour poster. Now, let me show you the tour shirt first. Here it is. Okay. Hopefully you can see it. It's got the tour dates on the back. Here's the poster. Got the tour dates on the bottom. I'm always a stickler for getting the concert posters. So it was pretty expensive, but that's typical with merchandise. But I think it's worth it. Now, one problem I always have getting these concert posters, which is so annoying. I feel like I deal with this all the time, is they'll give you the poster and they never have a rubber band, or they don't have a bag, or there's always some issue with getting the poster. This time they didn't have a bag or a rubber band, and me, as usual, I forget to bring a rubber band, so I had to go outside and like ask some lady to give me her fucking scrungie. So thank God I got that, because that would have been a pain in the ass. One thing I will note is this is the last concert on the Living the Dream tour. They've been touring for a while, so it's interesting that they would end up in Orlando. So I go back to the floor, and right when I get back to the floor is when the opening act goes on. Opening act is called Royal Tusk. I've never heard of them, and I was pleasantly surprised. They were a pretty good opening act, and the crowd seemed very receptive. So then finally around 8:45 to 9, Slash went on. Now let me read you the set list. The Call of the Wild, Halo, Standing in the Sun.
Yeah.
Apocalyptic Love, back from Cali, My Antidote. Serve you right. Shadow Life, We're All Gonna Die, Dr. Alibi, The One You Loved Is Gone, Wicked Stone, Mind Your Manners, Driving Rain, By the Sword. Train, Starlight, You're Alive, World on Fire, and Anastasia. It was about a 2-hour show. Jesus. I've never seen Slash solo. I've only seen him with Guns N' Roses, but man, it was an awesome show, as you could probably imagine. These guys have really good chemistry, and you can tell they've been together for a long time. Now, the rest of the lineup besides Slash is obviously Miles Kennedy on lead vocals, Todd Kearns on bass, Frank Sidoris on rhythm guitar, and then Shane Gollis on drums. Wait, who the fuck is Shane Gollis? Isn't it supposed to be Brent fucking Fitz? Well, actually, Brent had emergency eye surgery just a week or two ago, and he had to be replaced on the tour for the final few dates, so he handpicked Shane Gollis. And man, Shane Gollis did great. If you don't know anything about the band, you would have never known he was even a replacement. It was crazy, because when I was watching him the whole show, I thought he was like a young kid, like maybe my age and in his 20s, but I looked after the show and he's actually like 52 or some shit. And he definitely has a pretty large resume. So let me talk about some of the song and album distribution, which was really good. We got 7 songs from Living the Dream, 5 songs from Apocalyptic Love, 3 songs from World on Fire, 5 songs from Slash, and then one song from Appetite for Destruction. Ever since Slash rejoined GNR back in 2016, this band has kind of dropped most of their covers from the set list because they have so much material of their own that they can use now. And obviously Slash will just do most of the GNR stuff with GNR. I was a little disappointed we didn't get anything from Velvet Revolver or Slash the Snake Pit. I think everybody in the band had great energy tonight. Everybody was having a good time. Everybody played great. I have no qualms. I can't explain to you how in it the crowd was. The crowd was going crazy from start to finish, and I could definitely tell there were a lot of diehard fans in the crowd because a lot of people knew every word throughout every song and were singing along. I have a big schlong. I just had to add one more rhyme. As I said, they played We're All Gonna Die and Dr. Alibi. What's up with the fucking rhymes? Not a big fan of these songs. I wish they kind of replaced them with something else. Maybe Velvet Revolver or Slash the Snake Pit songs, as I said earlier. But these actually had Todd Kearns on lead vocals, which was a cool change. These were basically tributes to Lemmy, who sang lead vocals on them on the previous record. I gotta mention, on the song The One You Loved Is Gone, I know that's like a fan favorite, but I remember I didn't really care for it too much when I first heard it the first few times when the album came out. But watching it live was unbelievable. Slash's solo at the end on his double neck SG, his black one. Oh my god, it literally gave me goosebumps and the crowd was going crazy. This guy in front of me turned around and looked at me and he was like, "That was fucking amazing." And I'm like, "I fucking know." That was easily one of the best parts of the whole concert. I'm really, really glad they played Wicked Stone, Driving Rain, Mind Your Manners, and By the Sword. All a bunch of huge favorites of mine when it comes to Slash. Also extremely glad they played Anastasia. I knew they would pretty much play it, but as the show closer, it's perfect. I just cannot get over how good Slash's guitar playing is. It's so unbelievably good. There's no doubt in the world he's one of the greatest guitar players of all time, but when you see him live, it really just solidifies it. And to be as good and as fast as he is at the age that he's at is also extremely impressive. I think he's honestly better than he's ever been. So when it was all said and done, they were all throwing picks out and, you know, drumsticks out. I wasn't close enough to catch any, unfortunately. But one thing Slash said on the mic was that they'll be creating a new record with the Conspirators and Miles Kennedy soon in the future. Which I know a lot of people were worried about since Slash is with GNR again. But Slash is such a loyal guy. He has such a great time with the Conspirators and Miles Kennedy that he's not going to fuck them over and just like go to Guns N' Roses and never talk to them again. Like, no, he's going to continue making music with them. And I can't wait to hear it. One other thing I want to note is Slash didn't talk too much on the microphone throughout the whole show. It took him, I would say, 3/4 of the way through before he started talking on the microphone some. And it wasn't like it was something that bothered me. It was just something I noticed. The only little problem I had with the Hard Rock, if I want to nitpick the stage, I wish it was a little higher so the view is a little bit better. I feel like at the House of Blues in Orlando, it's a little bit higher where you can see the artist better. But there were some moments where it was kind of hard to see behind some of these fucking 6'7" people. Another little nitpicky thing about the Hard Rock is both times that I've gone there, it gets extremely hot on the floor. This is the only venue I've really had that problem with. So that's pretty much all I got for you guys today. I will be going to see Guns N' Roses in October. Slash is going to be going right back on the road, constantly working, which is super commendable. So I hope you guys enjoyed. Please comment, like, and subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one.